here tonight. All of us, quite frankly. We are talking about a man with right comedy, a man with sweet comedy. That's been performing for years, not just by himself. He's been a part of a duo for years, remember, from the days of Bello and Blacker. And he has, of course, penned many theater productions, produced them, directed them. He's a teacher by profession, by trade. He's a drama teacher, he's a literary arts man. This general here is what we call the master of the class. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm extremely proud to even be associated with Flatteries and to be called a comedian like that general. You understand what I'm saying? You understand what I'm about tonight?
Yeah.
And while we're in the green room, I'm going to tell you something. The room looks rich. Not about IT fancy camp, not about most of my flat, not about some of the best friends we have in the Jamaica in one room. And that is exactly what my dream was for the comedy band. To have the youngsters mixed up with the seniors, so I was attempting to grow the industry. Tonight, we get a chance to get a little master class tonight. So ladies and gentlemen, please, help me.
Ragging King. You know Ragging, my character in our movie years back, all the day come. But apparently my hottest thing now and the foot my young tune. I am out of the loop, I'm in an island target. But because I'm back in the classroom now, I learn, because I'm a teacher, that's how I learn. Because students tell me things, they say, I'm a shot now, Ragging King. First my hearing. Me hear a new one in my place with the head in the class, named Lali. But I'm glad, I'm really happy, proud and pleased that I'm part of a continuum. It's the Christopher Daly in the rating now. And years ago, I prophesied that he is the top Jamaican stand-up comedian. And some folks thought I was a Nicky Mills, I felt too early, but I can see things. I know Spartan is short, but I know for, you know. And me and Chris Barnes the same moment. So, you know, and look how we look like contemporary. Yeah. And when I'm born, me and 17 year old. I'm born like 3 days before my 17th birthday. You realize that?
Yes.
Yeah man, so me are kind of almost twin. A 17 year apart twin. But it's great to be here at this wonderful thing called Comedy Bar. Comedy, I go far, and it has come from far. You know, I'm not going to really respect comedians. They think comedians are idiots. And everybody is a great singer. And like everybody wanting a musician. I think singing is the only cultural thing in Jamaica. And them nowadays, you know, they say they might sing. They not sing. Today I saw some of the papers that they quoted a man who no culture. Edward George Phillips Yaka. But the man ate him in no culture. And they say, if you can whistle it on the music. I say, yeah, man, fuck this, I know. Can I try whistle in the Allen Jr.? Try whistle Lali, Shad and Dali. Try whistle Atami, Atami Lee. You can't do more than that. You can't whistle it. So things that time change, I mean, that's a funny line, but I have to embrace my age. I love old time days thing. When woman used to have a frock, not like the blouse, but Shelly and Lee Saban. She didn't wear a frock, no, she didn't wear a frock. She is, okay, Mrs. Daly, golden classic. Women wear brassiere. In my days, brassiere copper breast. No brassiere is like a tray. But you know, put the breast on. It's not copper, it's like, you know, it's like, it's weird. Things change. In my days, pan, you have to pan
cover button. You have to move panty to the button. No, you have to move button to the panty.
Always, nobody in the front but like no man. Ladies in the front to provoke people. And the man in the back, I know we have to make a man in the front. But the man did not prove it. The Jamaican men have a problem, a real problem. The young woman in particular, they must try to change everything the way they talk. You know, at you tell the young man, you see a tree tomorrow. Come on, don't say two. Really? Man no got Jim, man got Kim. Man no talk from Mike, man talk from Michelle. Jamaican man have a long list of don'ts. You wanna know what women do, cause your man no skin teeth, your man no laugh, your man no play, your man no eat ice cream unless he has a spoon, cause man no lick. In public. Man no eat banana all day after break it. Cause it might give people ideas. What's the that? And the man who do all these things, look, go no man to go be, girl to go be, girl chest up. And the man who look at your man a man. Them see man there, kiss him, on the bike, with a man on the back. And I'm like, you step out with your pants way down here. And jump on your bike, look at your man, a bad man, and a shatter on a bike. And I brush him, jump on the bike right there. And every time the bike, dolly, I took a break. Them are not shatter, them are batter. Them fist scatter. But them are the young man, a man. Me not trust them man there. They might try too hard to prove manhood. Yeah. Well, they might try too hard to prove masculinity. I missed the first time here. First thing I party, one man and one girl dance. Remember dancing? You dance with your partner. You know? You dance with your partner. You know, you're looking at her eyes, you know we are dancing. You can't see how I've known this man that I've been old like Bianca girl.
I'm a Bianca.
Like, is he that ugly? You can't face him? What's with that? And look at her party and ask a girl, may I have this dance? She looked bewildered. You want the whole dance? So, may I dance with you? She don't understand the whole concept of a man asking permission to intake your body with a partner. And normally you don't ask, just watch on and watch on. No communication. When we do say, no more, I'm done. She said, okay, dance now. And she did this. No, man, things are going to change. I miss first time this. When things were normal, when children were children, and adults were adults, and children wear children clothes. Anybody know those days? When picnic wear picnic frock, and big man wear big man frock. They just make some small big man frock now. That's your picnic frock. Girl just born of one brat at love. Boy just born of an ears ring, nose ring, ringing everything. And them are more everything nowadays, everything pierced. Children don't learn to enjoy childhood the way adults enjoy adulthood. I miss the first 10 days, man. I don't know what's happening with the world. I miss, and you know, I tell you about the line, you nice, affluent folks here, me born and grow. A 6A Upper First Street, Kingston 12, aka Trenchtown, aka Rima. I'm in never got jail yet. Yeah. My police have no arguments.
Now when I'm not on a board, I'm not going to jail. My auntie who raised me, I think I said, if she who loved me can beat me for her, imagine the police who don't love me. So you don't get to nothing with nobody. You grow good. You know how much time is that doctor? My other auntie Mary came to my doctor and tell doctor said, no chop out a tree. Can't lick me down. Can't keep up me. So auntie fling me down. My brother auntie, we grew up in separate households. But I didn't tell them why. Most of them have been hungry. They never have been hungry yet. Because auntie beat me good and feed me good and beat me hard. And looking back, we kind of upset with them, but no, I appreciate auntie. Because auntie, I try and avoid swearing. When I like a bad word. And some people look at it, never call them a prude. Because bad word, trigger me a bad word, because honestly, stop moving on me. Because my auntie who raised me, auntie every other word was a bad word. And she move her neck on every syllable. And they come forward by the glass. And say, how many?
Glass.
So when somebody, especially a woman, starts swear, or feel triggered to be like, we are getting beat now. Because auntie cuss. Me at school, I'm going to say, auntie, can I get my lunch money now? How many? I should tell you how your mother and father meet, how often they had intercourse, in what position, where in which corner, and a minute, I'm going to do it, and then she gave me lunch money. She now refused it, but then she had to go with the narrative. The step has gone. When school had opened, her auntie came for her back to school shopping. She walked in her store. I want to see that pair of shoes there. And I'm going to ask her. $300. You hear what it cost? $300. Dada, hiya. Mama, hiya. Papa, la. I should buy the pair of shoes. Then she's going to buy the car again. And it's getting better. She reach home. Everybody that downtown. No, all of my mother and father is me. I'm in a lie. So when I went to high school now, I tell my friend them with auntie going with, and they respond to his parents and think, oh, Ellis is a joker. They think my joke is a joke. They share my narrative. It was my therapy. And they beat this man and girl with their friend them, and they forget what they beat him. They laugh. They pick a joke, and a joke. And my reality. And auntie never know about fancy thing. You get a khaki shirt and pants in a grade 7. You are wearing that in grade 9. And the shirt gets charged, you buy some more khaki and store on it. You understand? And when you step up and bang over, you okay, when you strip your hand, the body has a two different khaki. Never do. If you hide it and I pick them up, that laugh. He was walking and go, ta-da! And then, why you booty wag? Then think I wear the shirt just to make them laugh.